Oh my goodness, the pressure.
Hard to watch. And it's all on the shoulders of a freshman. A child shall lead. Cameron Dicker from 40 yards away for University of Texas, Red River, immortality.
Center strike.
And we said it during the USC game when Dicker was 3 for 3 in his first game with an opportunity to kick, that confidence could take this Texas team a long way.
Well, I got to tell you, he's never.
One timeout left here for Texas Tech. 8 seconds.
Second down now. Deep strike. Got the big man. Crabtree pulls free. And touchdown. Red Raiders with a second to go.
Side.
And now Terrell's coming on the blitz, and Porter hits him just as he lets it go, and the ball is incomplete.
Tucker, another high short punt. Dustin Harris comes up, and the Aggies.
It's time to step up.
Blitz coming. Tannehill firing for Fuller. Fuller got it inside the 40. It's a first down. Tannehill. Great pickup by Molina on the blitz. Fuller deep downfield, and it was almost intercepted by Phillip. To the ground. Molina burst into the secondary. He's inside.
In that gap on the pole.
Third and one. Molina, first down. Before he's wrapped up. And this passion play hit Tannehill. Tannehill firing. Fuller's out there, and it's broken up. Tannehill steps up, throwing. Swope is really tangled up with Vaccaro.
Trio's a wide receiver in the entire nation. The secondary from Texas has won that battle.
That's he had dialed up. Tannehill gonna try to run it himself. Ryan's got good speed. He's inside the 20, and Tannehill is very inside 2 minutes. Tannehill, Fuller over the middle. Fuller inside the 5. Fuller for the end zone. Touchdown. Tannehill running by in time. Ryan firing into traffic and offs into the end zone tonight, and he needs to do it here for the Aggies. Bullock puts a foot to it. A return opportunity from the one for Diggs. Diggs a little seam and a big running. McCoy firing, and he almost had Davis, and a hit.
Personal foul. Unnecessary.
Ball thrown out just in front of the outstretch. I got it.
What?
Guys,
what?
Why?
For the horns. The controversial call. McCoy fires to Shipley. Shipley's knocked out of bounds. McCoy fires. Complete and a stop. McCoy fires, complete, first down. The 12th man bringing noise, Wrecking Guru trying to bring heat. McCoy scrambling, a lot of room in front of him.
Goodwin end around. He's knocked down immediately. On the ground, Cody Johnson. Justin Tucker from 40 yards out for the game. It's up. The Longhorns win it.
Mandel will hold it. Now they've officially made it 57 yards.
Remember, a blocked kick can go the other way, too. He's got to be careful and get it up.
On the way. No, returned by Chris Davis. Davis goes left. Davis gets a block. Davis has another block. Chris Davis. No flags. Touchdown, Auburn. As Gary said, it's a decent kick. Now, it will officially go into the books as a 100-yard return with a missed field goal because the NCAA does not measure from deep in the end zone.
Burnham's kick. Moore camps up. Fell down to the ball. Yeah. Is out. Picked up.
Can't run it. It'd be a muff.
It's Jahad Campbell who scored on a fumble return the last time we had these guys.
And this is going to be Alabama's ball. A slip. The Auburn player slips on the return.
This is Coy Moore. Even though it's zero, it's not Keontae Smith. And when he hit the turf, the ball came out.
Yep.
Ruth on the field as the punt was first touched by the receiving team, recovered by the kicking team. By rule, it's dead when recovered by the kicking team. First down, Alabama at that spot.
Milroe trying to be heard with his front wall. And they're going to toss it to Williams. Rodell Williams has got a first down.
Very clever play by Alabama. Well thought out, obviously practiced. They kind of lulled Auburn into thinking that they might call timeout or try to draw them off sides, and then they run the play.
Jermaine Burton in motion. And a bad snap, or Milroe wasn't ready for it. He goes way down. That's all it is. But there's a lot of airspace to cover for Milroe. Still looking. Firing. Near corner. It's caught! Touchdown, Alabama! Isaiah Bond! On a fourth and a mile!
We always keep thinking we've seen it all. And we never have we?
Bond, Isaiah Bond. Unbelievable. Which is the 1 yard line with 1 second to go. Thorne lofts one out, it is intercepted. Terry and Arnold will end it for the Tide, maybe with a touchdown. The craziest, most unbelievable final 40 seconds of football that maybe you'll ever see unless you've been to the Iron Bowl before.
That's exactly right.
For the lead. Blocked again! Cody again!
Oh my!
Alabama wins!
Well, Cody saved the day. He's right there. Number 62. His left arm again. This time he gets it with his hand.
Better and better here in the second half.
Sanders open. There he is again. Touchdown, Harrison. He gave it the I can't believe it either.
Sanders got rid of it. He got it. Weaver this time. If you didn't know this was a rivalry game, you know it now. Incredible drama and performance.
Really, it's just right here on the touchdown, you're going to see this against the cover two look. You're going to see the tight end go across the field, and then instead of just hooking up here, he turns it vertical and then gets down in between the hash and the numbers. Look at this. Look at this conversion. That's called, we know exactly the counter to cover two. And here, you just have some confusion on the outside here between the safeties and the corner. They're sending a max blitz. You see seven guys rushing here. And they just turn loose Weaver in the back of the end zone.
Nicolosi steps up into the end zone in a crowd. No good. Picked off by Woods and it's over. Buffalo's win it. Do you believe now? Let's decide it. Right here in New Orleans, Jaden Daniels. To the end zone. Got it! Jerain Jenkins! My, oh my, what a night in New Orleans!
College action to send us to overtime.
Of your screen. Thompson wants to throw it. End zone, has his tight end. Brewer! Touchdown, Texas! Not 100%, and somehow, some way, Texas has mounted a comeback to force overtime. Johnson, left side, strong finish, upended. Gain of seven on the first touch. Nate Betts brought him down.
But Roshan Johnson has come in and done a very good job.
Screen, Worthy, first down, stays in bounds. Touchdown, or did they call him out? That was close. First down and goal. Thompson. Touchdown, and Washington has it. Daniels, a gap. And brought down after picking up a first down. It'll be first and goal from the two. Lassiter in motion. Handoff, Neal. And they'll call it a touchdown, the late signal. Rolls in from the bottom of your screen. Here we go. Daniels, flushed. Daniels, end zone, caught! Kansas wins it! Jared Casey, the hero, and the Jayhawks find a way.
Well, Philly, remember why Jared Casey is even in the game. Your best receiving tight end, Mason Fairchild, got chopped to the ground and hasn't been in the game since. Jared Casey is a fullback. Don't you love this game?
57-56, the final score in...
Three-man rush.
Let's it go.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Oh, no. Ricardo Lewis.
Number 20. 25, Josh Harvey Clemens actually knocks it out of Trey Matthews' hands, number 28. It bounces up in the air for the most improbable touchdown you'll ever see.
Here comes the pressure. Corral towards the goal line. It is caught. It is a touchdown. Elijah Moore. And they're an extra point away from tying the game. And penalty markers get thrown after the play. The kick is up. And it is no good.
Steps away from the pressure, fires downfield, wide open's Gallen. They left him alone, needs a block. Now he's in a foot race. Out of bounds at the 15, and there's 8 seconds to go.
The Michigan defense makes some mistakes, and this time, even though they're in that Hail Mary formation, Brent, you said it, they just lost Gallen. Didn't even pay attention to him. They were locked into the middle of the field, thinking he may just throw it up to Hemingway, but he does a good job of improvising.
Starts Smith in motion. He's going to throw for it. He's got to throw it to the end zone. Lobs it up. One-on-one. Caught. Michigan touchdown. I can't believe this. Roy.
That one time on left. Rozier going to take a shot. And it is caught.
Miami 6 seconds away from ending the seven-game losing streak to Florida State. Badgley to make it a four-point lead. He was thinking he was going to have to come out and try a long field goal. Instead, he's just out there for the extra point to make it a
for the Volunteers. From 40. On the way, a knuckleball. He got it! Another look at the game's final play. The kick heard round the state of Tennessee and all of college football.
Question, no way to pick up a first down. You've got two cracks at the end zone and two chances to defend it.
Little throwback. Searcy decides to keep it. Dives for the end zone. Touchdown, Georgia Tech. Eight plays, 46 yards.
Dobbs heaves it. They're bunched up in the end zone. It's tipped up. It's caught. It is caught. Jawan Jennings. Jawan Jennings.
Here he is, the tallest guy. He did not get to the ball. And you know that unsportsmanlike penalty by Georgia cost them the football game.
Look at the leap of Jawan Jennings. He had the go-ahead catch for Tennessee in their win over Florida, and watch the coach for the Volunteers.
8 yard gain, second and 2 at the 3. He runs it again.
The Trojans force the turnover.
From 43 yards away. Clean snap. Good hold.
Ball game.
Point conversion call now. They had to use one to tie it. Yeah.
He scampers on the move again. Nope. And they stopped him. They stopped him. A flag is down on the play, but he did not get in.
We're the replay official right now.
is deciding whether the game's over or not.
In overtime.
In double overtime on a targeting call.
On Quincy McAdoo.
Who's had a tremendous night. Let's see.
And the replay official is David Lambros.
After further review, the ruling of a targeting with the crown of the helmet is confirmed. 15-yard of the penalties, half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
Option team with the blitz.
Nope. Daniels back, throws this one, and they do get in once again. And that's Jared Casey once again. Lofts this one, and he's got it to Binion. In the end zone for two.
With Bean in the game, and here it is.
Looking for that end zone. The throw, and it's incomplete. And Arkansas wins it.
At the end of the game.
55-53 in three overtimes. They win the AutoZone Liberty Bowl in the highest score.